Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome back to today's preview of the upcoming brand new DLC for Jurassic World Evolution 2, the Secret Species Pack. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Stegoceratops, one of those returning hybrids from the last game. Has it been improved? What new animations and stuff do we have to play with? And what new skins does it have? We're going to check out all of that in today's video. Let's get started.
The Stegoceratops is a hybrid that was engineered to wow the masses. It has everything. The horns, the frill, the plates, the spikes. This is a creation straight from the brilliant mind and laboratory of Dr. Henry Wu.
So, Stegoceratops, really cool exit animation, very dramatic, the way the camera pulls back as the Stegoceratops charges forward, and also very appropriate for Stegoceratops. You've got to imagine this is a creature that would be very, very willing to defend in a herd. You know, that first one bounds out, it's like checking the area, making sure everything is safe for its compatriots. So, let's take a look at the Stegoceratops. Let's pause that right there. I've already done a comparison in our previous video. There are very, very few differences between this and the Stegoceratops from Jurassic World Evolution, but I'm going to try to bring those up on the screen right now so you can at least get some sort of idea where the changes are. As I say, I don't think really much has changed between these two. The horns might be a little bit shorter and a little bit straighter, but really the main changes here are in the textures and assumedly in the animations as well. The textures are, of course, much, much higher quality. They're really actually very, very impressive on the frill in particular along the body. Looks pretty great. We can see the skin here. We've got this kind of like dappled sort of striping going along the body there. And of course, down here along the crest and over there on the stegosaur plates. And because this is a stegosaur ceratopsid hybrid, we also have a phagomizer here at the back. This thing, the plates, the gigantic horns. It's not even a triceratops anymore. It's a centroceratops with its five horns there. The plates, the phagomizer, the crest. It's a tough old critter. It's a tough old critter. It's not my favorite design because I think it looks a little bit too much like a Triceratops with some Stegosaur adornments rather than, you know, a real true hybrid of the two. But I will say it's made the transition pretty nicely into Evolution 2. Got this lovely green one. Of course, I'll show you all the skin colors at the end of the video in the Species Viewer. Going to show you some stats here as well. You can see Stegoceratops appeal 226, which is pretty good. Now, this is actually really interesting. You see it's got 2.2 times the appeal of the Triceratops, but the cost is actually a little bit less. I can see some of these new hybrids being very, very efficient for your challenge modes and stuff like that, because this is a very high value dinosaur despite the low cost. If we go over into our needs, you can see forest, ground fruit, water, and ground fiber. So it's got two different food needs. It's going to be a little annoying to take care of. Likes Stegosaurus, makes sense, and a bunch of other things. But dislikes Nasutoceratops taurosaurus. It's got some of those ceratopsid dislikes inherited from the Triceratops and also the Stegosaurid ones as well. It doesn't want to live with that many things, to say the least. And we can go over here into the attributes. It's not super strong. We can see attack 83, defense 41, leading up to a base dominance of 124. If we check that against the Triceratops, you'll see it goes down a little bit, but not much. It's 10 base dominance lower. So all those adornments don't really do that much. It's actually got lower attack and defense than the Stegosaurus, which makes no sense whatsoever. But it is what it is. So that is our Stegoceratops releasing in a batch size of 2 to 4. Now let's check out some animations. Thanks for that, buddy. Bit of a feeding animation there, really nothing unusual. You know, a dinosaur like this really only has one way to feed, and that's chowing down with those beaks. You can hear this little click as the beak comes together though, which is really nice. And if we swift over here, swift is the word there, we can see also the drinking animation. I really like this skin. I think the lower key skins, these like darker browns and greys and whites and stuff like that, really work well to sell it as a slightly more naturalistic creature, given how, you know, balls to the walls, bonkers it kind of is in some ways. I've just been watching it, you know, as I record this video and try to get the animations. I've got to say, it's growing on me bit by bit. I think the texture updates and the frontier patterns have gone a long way to making it feel more like a dinosaur. You could call it speculative. Very, very speculative. It's never going to be my favourite, but I do like the frontier skin colours at the very least. Exactly. Well done, buddy. Lovely preening animation there as it kneels down to the ground and scratches its chin across the floor. I think we might be about to see the social animation. I was wrong. I was very wrong. Okay, we're about to see the social animation. This one is waiting. This one is approaching. They're about to lock into their position as they do. And I think we want to be on this side. It's a little unfortunate in the shadow, but it is what it is. Pretty low-key as social animations goes. The first Ceratopsid, first Stegoceratops comes in. Kind of seems to, like, it's almost trying to flip it or something. It doesn't really move the horns much. It just kind of jams them under the leg. And the second one is not having any of that nonsense. I feel it plays out a bit weirdly, like the sound effects. I don't know. It doesn't even hook them under. It's just a little nudge, really. It's just a friendly little nuzzle and... yeah, the second Stegoceratops, maybe not that friendly feeling at the moment. Size-wise, the Stegoceratops doesn't actually feel any bigger to me. You can see them from the front here, you can see them from up here as well. Obviously, the plates are making it look bigger, but I would say they're actually basically identical in size. Obviously, we've got much bigger horns and stuff over here, but in terms of just sheer scale, I would say they're probably about identical. So I think what they've done is taken a Triceratops and thrown on the Endormans, basically, which is probably what I expected, but still. Right, anyways, next up, and the reason why we have a Triceratops in here in the first place, is because it's time to try out the combat. I'm hopeful. Shut up, Lambert. I'm hopeful that the Stegoceratops might have something combat-wise. You know, it's a really unique-looking dinosaur. It's got this Stegomizer, it's got these giant horns. What's it going to use? Could it possibly use both in combat to give it a little bit va-va-voom? Does appear then to have the Triceratops suite of animations. I really like that horn tussle. It's not one I see very much because we really just don't get Ceratopses in DLCs in this game, so it's a long time since I've seen it. But the way it kind of picks one up and tosses it to the ground. Tosses it? That's tosses and tussles. Tosses it to the ground. It is still a very, very cool animation. So I'm not seeing anything yet utilizing the Thagomizer or anything like that. Hopefully we can keep trying it out and hopefully we'll see something cool. Well, they started the fight, but the Stegoceratops was still asleep. So, it's getting chewed on whilst it's half asleep. I'm not quite sure what's going on here. But it's back awake, and the raptors are once again hunting it down. It sounds very mean, but I kind of want it to die. No, it's fine. It's doing okay. Plodding along. Aww. I tell you what, Stegoceratops, you put up a good fight. I've had to spawn about 900 Velociraptors to make this happen. I suspect on its own it would handle a pack of Velociraptors, like 5 or 6 Raptors, and not have too much trouble. I must say nothing special happening there with the pack hunt, so let's try the Stegoceratops against some slightly larger carnivores. Oh Okay, we're about to oh, no, you're dead. Oh, that little chirp it does is very cute, though. Well, so nothing unique there. We're going to try it out with a larger carnivore as well. I'm going to stick a Tyrannosaurus Rex in here and, you know, fingers crossed, maybe we get something cool. So I've made myself a Super Stegoceratops, you know, increased attack, increased stamina, increased defense, just to make sure we want to see you win this fight. Just before that, though, I want to point out that this is the Lux skin. They all have a Lux pattern in addition to their regular patterns. And thanks to that last free update, what we can do now is come into capture mode, go time of day, go nighttime, and see it in action. So that is the Lux Stegoceratops. Very cool. You can see it's picking out the top of the plates. We've got a lovely pattern. Sort of like a bursting pattern there, sort of descending down over to the eyes, over the frill, and then some very normal wibbly striping that Frontier loves to do so much. I've got to say, it's really cool being able to do this and like swap between them so quickly and really see the difference. Like I can kind of, actually, thanks to that new capture mode, I should be able to do something pretty cool here. So, daytime pattern, nighttime pattern, there you go. Very cool. Yeah, looks good. Big fan. Now you tell them, buddy. You tell them. So here we go. The culmination of the fight. Rex looking not fantastic, to say the least. And down it goes. Aww. Right. So, well done, Stegoceratops. You've defeated Tyrannosaurus Rex. How do you feel? Feels good. Right, so with that done, we're going to hop into the Species Viewer. I can't really imagine what else we would need to do for the Stegoceratops. So we're going to hop into the Species Viewer and check out all those skins in a little bit more detail. I'll see you there in a sec. So let's take a look at it in the Species Viewer. We've got here the default Sonoran Desert and no pattern on whatsoever. So as you see, tons of colours. Let's have a little look here. Sonoran Desert, Death Valley. Really like that one, actually. Great Sandy Desert, Champlain Valley, Salar del Huesco, Limpopo River, Killian Mountains, Yukon River, like that one a lot as well, Svalbard, Amazon Rainforest, Mangrove Forest, and Gambier River Basin. That's a really interesting one. Lots of brighter greens in there. Let's pick a good base one. It's usually Yukon River or something like that. And let's take a look at the patterns. So we've got Rana with the red and black. Kind of looks like it's blood tipped, which is pretty cool. Calcarana, which is more orange in colour. Lithobates with the red and the yellow. Pulcrana, just yellow. Papyrana is white with sort of a black stroke. And then this kind of very dark, sort of tepid purple colour on the crest and on the plates. And then, of course, we've got the Lux as well, and we can actually go ahead and just shoop, there you go. Nope, that didn't work. There you go, we can see that like that as well. So of course the Lux only comes in one color, which is this sort of greeny color right here. We don't get to change that, unfortunately, but there we go. Beautiful. And let's take a look at some animations. So we've got the standing, we've got the idle, which is, as we saw, that kind of scritch scratch along the ground. We've got a walk, we've got our bounding run, we've got a sit, hello buddy, and then we have the preening, which of course is the very always adorable rolling animation. There you go. And let's just get you back up there, maybe trotting along slightly. So that is the Stegoceratops, and I've been avoiding giving too many opinions throughout this video, so I'm going to do this now. This is actually the first video I've recorded for today. I've not done any of the other three dinosaurs in this pack. I've started with the Stegoceratops because I figured it'd be the easiest video, because, you know, these medium herbivores and the larger herbivores tend to have less animations. They don't tend to have that much new to showcase, and that of course has been the case with the Stegoceratops, which appears to have identical animations to the Triceratops. I don't want to say that 100% because, you know, as I've said countless times now, there's always a chance there's some interesting little combos out there that I just haven't seen. I think it looks okay. I think the Frontier skins are quite nice. You know, I'm kind of tired of the wibbly wobbly lines, but I think they've done quite well here. I think these are actually nicer than usual. There's a lot of variety in there, like this sketchy sort of nature. I think the drooping down on the crest there is quite nice on the frill, and the banding on the plates is pretty nice as well. So I'm quite happy with the skins. I think it's made the transition into Evolution 2 pretty well. However, I will say this is by far the least interesting dinosaur in the pack. This is the only one I find a little bit problematic because it hasn't really changed in terms of the model. The model is basically the same as it always was, albeit with some texture updates and the new skins and stuff. The animations are, of course, ripped straight from the Triceratops. There's nothing new in that regard as far as I've seen. So this one, compared to the Ankylodocus, which is remodeled entirely, the Spinoraptor, I haven't done it yet, but let's assume it's got a ton of new animations because it's a carnivore and it's a lot easier to do. And of course, the Spinoceratops is a whole new dinosaur. The Stegoceratops, in contrast, feels quite underwhelming. There's just nothing new here. There's nothing we haven't seen before. Even the social animation was a little bit dull. I feel like this is a missed opportunity wherein the Thagomizer could have been used. You know, no dinosaur in the game has horns and a Thagomizer. So why hasn't that been integrated into the animations a little bit? That would have been a lot more fun. So I'm a little bit disappointed in the Stegoceratops. This one feels like a, well, we need to fill out the pack. You know, we've put the work into these other three, well, the other two, and some animation work on Spinoraptor, I assume. We can just toss this one in. And I don't think that's okay for a dinosaur that we'd already paid for in the last game. I'll say that much. Your mileage will vary on that, of course. For some of you, you won't care at all. For some of you, this will be an absolute deal breaker. I'm not going to tell you how to live your lives. You know, it's completely up to you. Either way, thank you so much for joining me today. Please do throw me a like if you've enjoyed these videos. Stick around on the channel. We'll be covering the DLC more throughout the week, of course. And yeah, thank you for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.